We're here in chilly and Dicka Springs, Colorado, where the air is thin and the smoke is thick. It's Pop Brownie Day here at sold-out No Authority Field. And the crowd is fired up for some football after an intense pregame screening of 2001 A Space Odyssey. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers and lots of beers. The Orcs of Hazzard battle the Mile High Chronic. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello, once again, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
Huh?
Hey, how'd your checkup go?
Well, good news, bad news. Doc says I passed my physical.
Oh, that's good.
But I fucked my mental.
Not too good.
Well, it's 50-50. Better odds than I get in Vegas.
Get a point. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB. Oh, the strawberry field's dirty trick. As my mentor Hunter used to say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Down and long. You can tell he's a berserker because he's dropping at the mouth.
Oh.
And there's an 8-yard catch.
Chipping away with those medium passes, I like it. Like a patient prison break.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. You gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
Like play of the day brought to you by the good folks at Speedy's Drive Through Funeral Parlor Service, located just off the Beltway Exit 5. And it's first and 10.
The way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, hitting him a pick. 8 on the play. Second down and 2. I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating for... Oh, and the defender cut off that pass like a... Oh, with the brutal hit! And it's first and 10.
All you mutants out.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay!
And it's first and ten. Cannonball first. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
First and goal. The defense had enough with this rep and jumps on sides to kill him. And it's first and ten. And that pass finds its target. A pickup of 6 yards on the play. And that'll be second down and four. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schlong Galaxy phone.
And it's first and ten. And it's first and ten. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Second down and ten.
Another interception.
Boom! And it's first and ten. Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and nine. Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Right now, what day is it?
second down and 10.
Checking off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Hey, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And it's first and 10. It's a sack. The quarterback has to get rid of the ball there. Second down in a very lot. Third down and the punter is warming up. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
Quarterback didn't like that last play, so he decided to undo it with a time warp dirty trick.
I don't trust quarterbacks with that kind of power. First it's plays, what's next? Bribe a ref, then take your money back. Data model, then take your money back. It's a slippery slope, Grim.
That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit.
Love the sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not your own.
Second down and 5. And we've got a tight battle here as quarter one comes to an end.
Oh, that was a snooze fest.
Second down and 5. Down to 9. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
And a thought being snagged.
Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. First and 10. They're taking what the defense has given them. That's a 4-yard gain on the reception.
Hey, less than a wipe with a headed.
Second down and 6. The nasty. Boy,
other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. And it's first and 10. He picks up 5 on that play. The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only 2 left. They might consider running the ball more. Second down and 5. And with another pick, the QB. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit. First and 10. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback, pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? First and 10. He's got his feet and he breaks away. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And that'll be second down and 4. Rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than complete. Oh, what a punishing hit that was! And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Defense gives up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Wham!
The offense lost their last running back on the previous play. Next time the offense comes out in the field, they will have no running plays. And it's first and 10. And picks up maybe a deuce at most. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. And that'll be second and 8 to go. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
That ball was almost intercepted. The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got...
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
First and 10. down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Third down in the offense. The warning sounds. Only 2 minutes left in the first half. Third down and forever. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. First down and 7. And I've had it. I'm running out of power with the brain scrambler. And it's 1st and 10. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. 2nd down and 10. The defense quickly calls a timeout. They want to get the ball back. 3rd down and, well, good luck. Quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And it plays a defense, schmuck.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. Straight through the uprights. The offense lost their final quarterback. Lucky for them, they're on defense now or the game would be over.
So all the other team has to do is punt to force a forfeit?
That would be correct, Bricks. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsatan Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked down? What do you do then?
Run. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
I personally think the giant...
And then he jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. Oh, man, I'd rather watch my big toenail being removed by a weasel than watch this.
That's how I got rid of my toenail foot fungus, Grim. Found this weasel on the internet that did it for a can of sardines. Cheap. It pays to be smart when it comes to medical procedures.
They're going for 2 points. No one was going to stop him. That's 2 points. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. The offense is down to their last quarterback. If they lose him, they lose the game. And it's first and ten. Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Second down and ten. Third down and long. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
With no players left on their roster and an empty bag of weed, the Mile High Chronic loses by forfeit. It was close for a while, but in the end, it was just too much for them, and they couldn't get it done.
Sounds like your wedding night, doesn't it?
Hey, there's a pills for that. You know that commercial where they show a mummy getting a boner?
What the hell are you talking about, Bricks?
I don't know. I get confused often. I'm on a lot of painkillers.
Well, moving right along, let's hear what the MVP has to say. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it, so...